101.7 FM.
So gracious and so divine.
Joy 99.7 FM and also on Joy Prime. My name is Adam Knight Tay, and this is Home Affairs. Our mandate is to make homes out of houses, and that's what we always do. Now, by way of encouraging you this morning, usually my message is just very, 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 very simple. And today I go back to a message that I have shared with you before, and it's just because of the personal experiences that I go through as well. And it's simple. Tough times don't last forever. Bad times do not last forever. At the time when you're going through it, right, you would feel like the world is coming to an end. Or sometimes you would wish that the world comes to an end so that you're free. But if you will tarry a little bit, have a little bit of faith, encourage yourself and stay positive, it will pass. It surely will pass. It is that waiting period that's very difficult. But if you believe in God, you believe in Christ like I do, and you commit a bit of prayer to it and have a little bit of faith and keep a positive attitude, it surely will pass. So when you're going through very difficult times and it's seeming as though the whole world has turned against you, just encourage yourself and assure yourself that bad and tough times do not last forever. They surely will pass. And if you're going through any difficulty this morning, for those of you who are bereaved and, you know, maybe putting your family members to rest today, if you are not well, whatever difficult situation that you may be going through today, I pray for strength for you. My very, 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 very good colleague, Enimua Enimadu, for instance, is putting her father to rest this morning. We will be there, Enimua, to support you. So wishing you the very best, wishing you all the strength you need in this world. And to you, Don Chega, as well, you are also, you know, putting your sister to rest today. Well, with you in spirit. And to everyone who is going through, who is grieving this morning, we pray strength for you. And just know that God is always by your side. One more time, this is Home Affairs. We are live on your superstation, your radio for discerning listeners, Joy 99.7 FM and on Joy Prime. Last week, we started a conversation with the gynecologist, and we're just doing Q&As. We're taking your questions. We could have a topic to discuss, but maybe that topic is not answering a peculiar question for you. So we decided that for this week and hopefully next week, it depends on Doc's availability, we will be taking your questions and then he will answer them. And mind you, you hearing the answers to your questions here doesn't mean that you don't go to the hospital. This conversation is actually to let you know, uncover some of the things that you may not be understanding, and for you to follow up and get further diagnosis, especially if he recommends that for you. So, Dr. Paddy Ayeta, good morning and welcome one more time.
Good morning and thank you very much.
Today you have taken yourself, pal.
Oh, I have armed myself against the AC. I'm fine.
So this one is really not for the cameras, it's for the AC.
Oh, it's for the AC, Are there cameras?
There are cameras. So,
you mean they can see my face?
Everybody's looking at you, and at your beautiful, you know, polka dot jacket. You're looking very sharp.
I can't go to the roadside and buy watch anymore.
Oh, oh my God. You are a star.
That is what concerns me.
Oh my world, dog. Anyway, I keep forgetting your new place, oh.
Elimas Health.
He is the medical director at Elimas Health. He is, like an advanced Medibia Kawama, no? Advanced gynae and ops, you know, consultant and all that. By the time we finish, if this is the first time you're meeting with him, by the time you finish, you will know his quality. But Doc Akwaba, again, let me remind our listeners that Home Affairs is brought to us by Korba Payments App. Korba spelled K-O-R-B-A, our life simplified, Onga, Mama's Helping Hand, and Kel Kids Toothpaste for children between 2 and 6 years. A product from Samara Company Limited. Kel Kids, happy smile. Welcome on board, and I also remind you of our Drive Safe campaign, which is brought to us by Joy News and the Multimedia Group, and we are supported by Toyota Company Limited, Toyota Ghana Company Limited, Toyota Superior Quality. Avoid all distractions. Ensure that you're keeping both eyes on the road and your hands on the steering wheel. Be visible means that when you're driving, especially at night, drive with your lights on, and that's how you ensure your safe arrival. So we go on straight to our questions. We have the first one. You can actually interact with us on WhatsApp 055-1111-997. Number again is 055-1111-997. And then our phone line, we will activate it in just about 30 minutes, 0302-216541. Today, we're going to be breaking into the conversation a little bit for just about 5 minutes and tell you a little bit about Adansi Travels. They're here. They just might convince you, Doc.
Ooh,
tell you about the tours they have coming up. But ahead of that, our first question is popping up already. Hello, Doc. I am in my late 30s and got pregnant for the first time in 2016. I had complications, which led to an abortion in January. That's after 5 months, and that's in 2017, and left my cervix opened. Ooh. I have done several tests and scans after that, and up until now, I haven't been able to get pregnant, and it's a cause for worry for my husband and I. What do I do?
First of all, we are really, really sorry that you lost that pregnancy in 2017. Getting pregnant is not easy.
Yeah.
Carrying it for 5 months is not easy. After all the vomiting and everything, then you lose it. You have to start all over again. It's extremely distressing. The reason most of the time I relate, if it's early pregnancy, it's related to the pregnancy itself. If it's after 3 months, it may be related to the cervix. And where she describes the fact that the cervix is opened. But her challenge now is that it seems that she's not getting pregnant subsequently.
Mm-hmm.
And there could be various reasons that why that could happen, either from the uterus itself, or from the tubes, or ovulation, or from the sperm. For the duration of time that has passed, I think it's been too long.
Yeah.
And the important thing is that she needs to see a fertility specialist for the person to try and investigate
from
it properly.
2017
yeah, it's too long. Yeah. She needs a proper, detailed investigation to find out where exactly the problem occurred.
Okay.
And then intervention started taking place. She didn't mention whether her periods are coming.
Okay.
Sometimes after this kind of problem, the periods stop coming or become very scanty.
Mm.
And that tells us that it's from a particular condition.
Okay.
Which if you fix it after a few months, she'll be positioned to actually get pregnant again. Yeah.
Okay. So yeah,
it can be fixed.
It's taking a bit too long, Doc says, and so you need a proper investigation. Please follow up real quick. Doc was wondering if you're still having your regular menses. If you're able to follow up with that, I think it might help with, you know, some more information for you. How are you, Adam and Doc? We are good by the grace of God. When can you identify normal discharge and bad discharge during sex? This is from Daniel Autry. Discharge from who? The man or the woman?
I'm assuming it's from the woman.
The woman.
The simplest thing is if it smells.
Okay.
There's a particular smell that you may notice at the beginning, but as sex goes on, it gets more and more and more and eventually fills the room.
Really?
Oh yeah, the smell just keeps, you know, escalating. So if it has that particular kind of smell, it tells us a particular kind of condition that it can be fixed. For some, that is for the smelly part.
Okay.
If the discharge has a funny color, greenish, frothy, that is not a color, but you know, frothy in appearance. If it's thick, like curdled milk, or like clumps of cheese,
I see.
And it's causing her to have an itch. Those are the things that when we look at to suspect that indeed it has there's
a
problem,
challenge
with it. But oftentimes, or if of course if there's blood inside too, the question is why you shouldn't be having blood if you're not in your menses. So that's also a problem. But oftentimes, a woman may produce a whitish discharge that may be slightly thick, which is non-itchy, non-smelly, non-irritating. It's just, and that's just a normal secretion.
Okay.
You must be aware of the fact that the vagina contains organisms which are healthy and are supposed to be there, and produces a certain amount of fluid, which is also healthy and is supposed to be there. So the fact that there's some fluid is coming out and it's whitish doesn't necessarily mean that it's an infection. For us to know, we'd ask for a swab. Once we do the swab and we send it to the lab, it will tell us what the problem is, and we can tell you if you need treatment or it's just a normal secretion that should be okay. left alone. So that's it.
All right. So you need medical attention maybe, so that they're able to tell whether this is okay, is this normal, or...
I mean, if of the things I've mentioned, if any of them are inside, he knows that it's a problem, it should be fixed.
Great.
If none of them are inside, then still have it checked, but most likely they'll tell you there's nothing inside.
Okay, great. And then, you know, that will allay all the fears. Mm. I would want to have it checked, so why not? Adam, why do some women still menstruate and only realize they are 4 or 5 months pregnant? Uh-huh, that one.
For the clients that I have seen that have that story,
yeah.
When you probe and you probe, and you probe.
Okay.
What they were having is not exactly what they were having when
they were not pregnant. Okay.
So she sees a drop of blood one day, or a little bit of blood for half a day, and she says that to her, that's her menses. Meanwhile, you are a 7-day bleeder. Half a day is not a normal menses for somebody who normally bleeds 7 days.
I see.
You understand?
Yeah.
And the bleeding that you had was not exactly 28 days after the last one. But oh, she's seen her menses.
But how can you see your menses for just a day or half a day like
that? They conclude that. So, for you know, you keep asking questions. Exactly, how were you bleeding? How often were you bleeding?
I see.
Then after, okay, give me the date for last month. Give me the date for the month before. Give me when did it start? When did it end?
Mm.
Then you realize that the stories are not consistent with what was happening before. So that she has definitely had a change in her menstrual pattern.
Okay.
It may not be total absence of blood. And you must also remember that there's something called bleeding in pregnancy, where even though you are pregnant, you will bleed. Because maybe the pregnancy is trying to spoil what we call a threatened abortion, a threatened miscarriage. You could also bleed because of, and that could be due to a hormone imbalance. The result, therefore, is that you may see some blood in early pregnancy, and as a result of that, think that you are menstruating. But if you are aware of your normal cycle, you would recognize the fact that there is a significant difference between the bleeding that you saw and what happens during your normal cycle.
I see. So what? Doc, I've also heard that, you know, several times, that people say they have their normal menses, and yet they're pregnant. Is it such that when you're pregnant, you really can't have your normal menses? That can happen.
When you're pregnant, you should not be having your normal menses.
Okay.
When you're pregnant, you may have bleeding.
But that's
in
not
pregnancy.
Menses.
But that is not necessarily menses.
But when you have it showing up about the same time that you usually would have your menstruation, and this goes on for like 4 to 5 months, like they're saying, how do you interpret that?
So if that is why I said, if for the clients that have come with that story, when you start asking and you probe those questions, you will discover that whatever bleeding she was having cannot be equated to what she normally has.
Okay.
You understand? There's always something that makes you realize, but there's a difference between what your normal menses was and what is happening.
It is now.
It's happening now. And then you investigate further. People are sometimes not as aware of what their normal is. Therefore, even if there's a variation, there are people who come and say, you ask them, what's your normal menses? They give you a date, they give you a range. Then they tell you 28 days. Then you say, okay, last month's one was on what date? Then they check their calendar, they give you the date. Say, oh, but madam, that is 25. Then they go, eh. So why do you tell me 28? So it is usually
around 20.
You understand? But when was it 20? Then give me the previous month. Oh, 22. Give me the previous month. 20.
So it's irregular.
So you realize that she actually does not know exactly what her cycle is. And we have based our conclusions on the information she's given, which is actually not very good information. When we are calculating the months and the days in pregnancy, so how many months or how many weeks you are, we look for your last menstrual period and we assume you are 28 days. If you are not, calculation is wrong.
I see.
So somebody can come, when you start asking details and you actually probe, it's really important to get the dates right because your end result is based on that information.
Doc, sometimes the periods, they have their mind of their own. No?
Precisely.
They have a mind of their own. So, yeah, you think it's 28. And you see, especially so when you're not expecting pregnancy.
You're not trying for pregnancy at all.
You're not, exactly.
It's nowhere
any near. Day is day.
Any day is day.
You want it to come and then you're free. So, all right. So, the explanation is that truly if you're pregnant, you shouldn't be menstruating. Maybe you would have bleeding. But then again, I think it is dangerous to probably wait and be seeing the same kind of thing for 4 to 5 months before being alarmed, you know. If it was me, by the time I am seeing it for the first time, I am running to the hospital to go find out what is wrong with me. But some of us, we have passed that stage. I have this problem of bleeding for days after I have sex immediately after ending my period. Do you understand the import of that? Mm-hmm. What could possibly be the reason?
Okay, so when you have your body goes through a cycle, what we call the menstrual cycle, okay. And that cycle is regulated by hormones. So what happens is that one of your hormones drop, and when it drops, it allows the lining of the uterus to be shed.
Okay.
That shedding is the menses. The shedding process is supposed to go on for a certain number of days, and then another hormone starts rising.
Okay.
That hormone that rises stops the bleeding. Some people have a problem with that other hormone that rises to stop the bleeding. The result of which is that the bleeding does not stop totally. And the result, and so there's still some blood left in the uterus, but it's not always enough to come out. Then due to the vigorous activity during sex, the uterus gets shaken a little bit, and the blood that was left inside there that hasn't come out fully now starts coming out. And comes out in pieces, pits, and trenches. There are those also who have problems, not necessarily from the uterus itself related to the period, but the bleeding could also come from the cervix. Basically, if you are bleeding after your menses has ended, we are concerned.
Okay.
And especially if you tell us that you are bleeding after sex.
Mm-hmm.
Because the major concern about that is cervical cancer.
Okay.
Or an abnormality with the cervix.
Okay.
The bleeding from the uterus, if you're younger, most likely is hormonal. But if it's from the cervix, we are worried about cancer. And so for that reason, if you're having any kind of bleeding after sex, we would like to know.
All right. Real quick. While I wait to take the next question, let me ask you, do you know about the new Delicious? I'm talking about Ungalicious. And that is actually the new Delicious. Create those amazing moments with your favorite Unga seasoning. No matter your cooking experience, Unga is a delight to make great tasting meals in every home. Unga is convenient to use and it brings out that great taste and aroma in your meals. Let's toast to the new Unga chicken tablet with superior taste and comforting aroma for all your chicken meals. Unga, mama's helping hand. Unga, proudly Ghanaian. Connect with the team at Unga at Unga Ghana on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And everyone can use Koba. It's got a payment channel for the big bosses, the market woman, the mechanic, the cocoa seller, and the small shop owner. Sit back, relax, and simply pay for your old Students Association dues and contributions. transfer funds across all bank accounts or mobile money wallets, top up airtime and date and pay and data, pay your insurance, your TV subscription, utility bills, pay school fees, and pay for that watchy. Do all these and more on Cobra and get a free life insurance cover with Prudential Life while you transact your business on Cobra. Use Cobra and enjoy life's little pleasures. Download Cobra on Play Store or App Store via the WhatsApp channel, or you can also download it via the WhatsApp channel 0242-426186, or you can just dial *365# and follow the prompts. Cobra, our lives simplified. And have you tried the new NutriDay yogurt? It is Ghana's newest delicious and nutritious yogurt from farm milk. NutriDay contains zinc to support your immune system and vitamins A and B12 for good eyes and mind. Try NutriDay today. NutriDay, strong every day. Now my next question has popped up already. I have this severe waist pain when I am about having my menses and it goes away after it. Is it normal or should it be a cause for concern?
People have pain during the menses. The pain may be located anywhere down
sometimes
in the
pelvis. Sometimes pain in your thigh.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yeah, I know that one. So it's possible that this is just what we call a dysmenorrhea, which is painful menses, and there's no like organic cause. You can't find that there's something, a lesion or something that needs to be addressed. The fact that it goes after, just after your menses goes, it tends to be a good sign. So it may be nothing. It may just be related to your menses. If it's persistent, sometimes it's like, you know, have it looked at, but most of the time, it's related just to the menses, and it may not be anything.
For some people, some of these things replace the calendar because you're unable to follow it. So you start experiencing this, and you go like, oh, these people are coming
again,
back.
Yeah.
And then you give yourself like 2 to 3 days, and then they're here.
And after that, it just goes away.
You know? And especially so when you have had it checked or you have had conversations and you're told that, oh, it's just, you know, part of the things that you go through as a woman. It becomes the calendar for some people. Okay, so we're with the next question. You can call us on 0302-21654. And good morning. Thanks for the great show. Please, my name is Abna from Nungwa. I mostly have my menstruation early in the month. Last month, it came twice. Early in the month, as usual, that I don't get. And then it came again at the end of the month. This month, I haven't had it yet. Please ask Doc if this is normal. Should I be worried?
No, she shouldn't be worried. It sounds very normal.
Really?
Okay, so let's assume you have a 28-day cycle. And your menses comes on the 2nd.
Mm-hmm.
Or let's say the 1st. The next menses, the next bleed, if it's 28 days, will be on the 29th.
Okay.
Both of them will be in the same month. So assuming she had her menses last month, and she had it on the 1st of June. Her next bleed will be 29th. I mean, assuming she's got 28 days.
Okay.
Her next bleed will be on the 29th of June. Her next bleed would be on the 27th of July, which is not
and
yet.
This one would have traveled into July if
yes.
it came on the 29th.
Mm.
And so by the time you're bleeding again on the 27th of July, then it's seeming as though you have had two bleeds in a month.
Last month, and then you've had only, and you haven't yet had one this month.
Okay.
So the 28th still works.
Okay.
It's just a matter of when it occurred.
And then when it's next occurring.
Yeah, in the cycle. So that works out fine.
So what Doc has said, you're covered. But if it is, you know, if you're describing something more than what he's saying, then you probably will have to let us understand better, or you can still book an appointment and then have the conversation properly and make sure that your fears are allayed. But if this is what, if his understanding of your message is what it is, then you're good. Good morning. After my 3rd child, my menstrual cycle kept changing. Sometimes 35 days, 27 days, 28 days. I hope there's no problem. I wasn't keeping track of my cycle previously, and this is gifts 37 years.
Yeah, indeed. Obviously, whatever is happening to your cycle has not affected your ability to have children.
Okay.
So that's good news. your 35 to 27 days is still within what we describe as a normal range for menses. On the surface of it, just like that, it shouldn't be something that should bother you too much. It hasn't gone, you know, too far apart. Sometimes there are problems that this could be a very early sign of a problem, but most of the time it's not. So if it bothers you, have it checked.
That's all.
If it doesn't bother you, you can give it a little bit more time and see whether it's going to correct itself. Sometimes too, if you lose a little bit of weight, it helps. So hey, try and lose 10% of your weight, assuming that you are what we will say a little bit overweight, and you may notice that your menses would automatically come back to a regular one that you can predict with and live with. Hey, then we don't like the losing weight part. Hey,
no, I like that one. I like that one. I was just gonna say that. See this menstruation thing there. If there is no problem, they should just behave. They should just behave. So, like I said, they have a mind of their own, you know. And then sometimes they get you overly worried. Hey, what is happening? Like I said, especially so when you're not trying for pregnancy and you probably may be suspecting that you may have had an accident. Mm-hmm. You know, you said that thing,
I have to follow up on that accident. Hi, I'm sure you're listening.
You may have had an accident, you know, and then you realize, and you're so worried, and then you realize that, oh, okay. It was just a scratch, So it should just.
But we should take those as warnings. So when you have near misses, a near miss usually means, Charlie, do something about it too, because proper accidents can happen.
Oh, we did say that we were going to have a bit of conversation around
about the emergency
contraceptives. Okay, great. We will come to it very shortly. They called, they answered, they conquered. Congratulations to all the winners from the new Geisha Black and Moringa game show, our natural girls and boys. We hope you finally got to experience the glowing, soft, moisturized and smooth skin benefits from using the new Geisha African Strength Moringa and Black Soap. Share your experience with us, because the world has to know that the new Geisha African Strength is ideal for all skin types and will bring out the natural you. Share your story with us today. New Geisha African Strength, proudly African, made by Ghanaians for fellow Ghanaians. Do remember that T's and C's apply. Okay, let's answer this question and then we will go to talk about emergency contraceptives. Good morning, Adam. Please, my period came in April. Okay, today looks like a menstruation day. Mm-hmm. Please, my period came in April. And till now, nothing for the past 3 weeks. I feel pain. This is from Didi in Lashibi.
May, June, July. That's about 3 months. Almost 3 months. Apart. About 3 months without having a menses. I think there's a problem.
Could she be pregnant?
She could be pregnant. And obviously, she's not planning a pregnancy.
Exactly.
In the light of her message.
Exactly.
So, she could be pregnant. She could have other problems. Anything from breast milk hormone to other kinds of hormones that will cause the periods not to come. Stress sometimes can cause your period to misbehave, but it usually wouldn't do that for 3 months. It would delay it for about a week or two, or even three, but 3 months I think is a bit much. This is one of the cases that I would suggest that please have it investigated. See your doctor, have a chat about it. Let him try and find out why the menses is not coming. Because it's funny, sometimes this is the first sign that we'll discover that you are having a diabetes problem.
Okay.
Or a thyroid problem. But actually discover that you actually have that problem. It's only because your menses didn't come or misbehaved for a little bit. So it's good for her to have it attended to. She should see her doctor.
Great. You should have it checked. From what Doc is saying, you don't just relax on it and assume that, oh, it's nothing. Especially so after you send the message, then it looks like you're worried and concerned about it too. So please have it checked. What can one do to control hormonal imbalance that causes unwanted growth? Okay, ahead of that, we will talk about...
unwanted growth where?
Okay, she didn't...
Can she tell us where the growth is?
Okay, so please complete the message
you sent. Is she talking about hair on the hair? pimples.
So she wants to find out that causes unwanted growth. So what kind of unwanted fibroids? Growth? Uh-huh. So please let us know, and then we may be able to zero in on it. So emergency contraceptives. Mm-hmm.
So first of all, we have sex,
mm-hmm.
which is nice, pleasurable, if done right, and is not purely for procreation.
Yeah.
We do also are also aware of the fact that to ensure the sustainability of the species, the female has an increased desire for intimacy around the time when she's ovulating.
Okay.
That's how we're made. That's how we're created. We do, however, have choice where we have to choose when to have a child. And there are various methods by which we can use to prevent unplanned pregnancies, of which there are about maybe, let's say, 14 different methods available. So we have that to use. In the event that our regular method, fails, you know. So I'll say that method is like when you're driving, your foot brake. When somebody crosses the road, you step on the brake. And you're on the turn junction, you step on. That is how we use that for our day to day. In the event that the unexpected happens,
mm-hmm.
the condom breaks, you didn't intend to have sex and you were forced to have sex, you know, things of that sort, we had to find a different method to try them as a backup. But you know, backups don't always, you know, they don't always where you're
plan B.
They don't, it is not the main method. It is, in case you fall from the plane, there's a parachute. You're not intended to fall from the plane, but there's a parachute. Some parachutes will not open, but for maybe the majority to open and save your life. So for that reason, we had to find something that would act as a parachute in case there's a plane crash.
Yeah.
And that is how the emergency contraceptive came about. Now, the purpose of it is to try and create an unfavorable environment to prevent a pregnancy from staying.
Mm-hmm.
That is basically how it works.
Yeah.
Because it's like the pregnancy is inevitable, but we are going to create a hostile environment to prevent it from staying by using that medication.
Okay.
It must be taken as soon as possible after you've had the unprotected sex or the accident. So I've had sex. Oh, it's unplanned. I may get pregnant. You take it.
Okay.
That is how it's intended to work. And if you do take it, it will stop some pregnancies.
Mm.
However, it messes up your hormones for that cycle. Okay. Because you are going on a particular path and we give you the medication and it messes up the hormones. So it's intended to use, and it's not 100%. Its failure rate is a lot higher than the regular contraceptives.
I see.
So you're driving down the road and somebody crosses you and you step on your brake and your brake fails.
Wahala.
You are going to hit the car ahead of you. So you decide that, hey, let me just pull the handbrake and see what it will do. So you pull the handbrake and if you are lucky, you may not hit the car ahead of you. If you're unlucky, you may somersault and fall into the ditch and break your neck and die. Those things happen. But you are not intended to drive on a day-to-day basis using the handbrake as a method of slowing your momentum down.
Mm.
Unfortunately, people think that they will not use contraception. They will have unprotected sex.
And then
they'll use an emergency contraceptive every day.
People use it every day.
It is the height of dumbness.
Wow.
I was talking to a client of mine yesterday. She said she cannot understand how this particular girl can come to the shop every day or every other day and come and buy emergency contraceptive. She said one day she nearly got up to call the guy and said, hey, madam, why? Stop this. If you know you're going to have sex, get proper protection. Just get proper protection. There's the pill, there's the condom, there's the IUD, there's the implant, there are different kinds, the 3-year implant, the 5-year implant, there's female condom, there's non-latex condom, the silicone-based ones, there's the diaphragm, the options are plenty. You can take the injectable that you take one injection every 3 months, you will not get pregnant, and even the good thing about that one, so the periods to diminish to almost zero. So some people take the injection quietly and their periods are very scanty. No pain, no wahala. They have their peace of mind. You know,
I see.
Take something.
But doc,
And in addition to all this, you are exposing yourself to infections.
Yes.
HIV, hepatitis, all those things. Cervical cancer. Why?
I wanted to find out. So why don't people like to use the regular contraceptives?
Because they've heard all kinds of funny stories.
Exactly.
And they haven't gone to inquire them for themselves. Somebody comes and tells you a very funny story, says, in a situation like this, why are you not on contraceptive? I hear there are side effects. Then I ask them, have you heard of plane crashes? Yes. They say yes. If I give you a ticket to go to America right now, will you go? They say yes. Are you not... Don't plane crashes suck? Haven't you heard about plane crashes? You say, but that one, I want to go to America. I'm like, okay. So we sort of compartmentalize ourselves. We think that, oh, we've heard this, and we think somehow that the risk of the side effect is so high that, you know, because of that,
you'd rather do
you'd rather
go.
and risk a lot more. You understand? I mean, what are the side effects? You give you the injectable, your periods may stop. That's a side effect of the injectable. Your periods may stop.
But is that is that good?
Yeah, it's okay. Your body has been told, Master, baby is not coming. The Vista is not coming. Don't lay the bed. There's no point in laying the bed if Vista will not come and lie on it. Why are you laying in bed every month when you know that Vista will not come and lie on it? So don't bother.
I see.
And when we take you off the injectable, within 3 to 6 months, your menses comes back. Maximum 9. If we tell you that from the beginning, you know that you are normal. It is just a variation that has occurred because of the drug. And once we take it out of your system, it comes back to normal. You'll be fine.
Mm.
You put the implant in your arm, side effect, sometimes you have spotting.
That's the one.
If you are spotting, we can fix it. That's medication. We should tell you from the beginning.
That you may spot.
If you spot, come and see us. We'll give you medicine that will stop the spotting. It may come back in 6 months' time, but it's okay. Just know that when it comes, we'll fix it. And then for the next 6 months, you'll be fine.
For the next 6 months, you won't have your menstruation?
Yes. No, you have your menses, but the spotting may not
in
come back.
Yeah.
Then the next 6 months, it may come again. We'll fix it. But after that, it may not come back again. As in, the spotting may not come back again. Your menses will reduce in amount, it will reduce in volume, maybe number of days, but it's normal. It's just the medicine that is just basically telling your body that don't prepare for a pregnancy. Your period is preparing for pregnancy. Don't prepare because pregnancy is not going to come. Yes, you use the condom. Side effects, you have a slight reduction in sensation. People are working about the premature ejaculation. They should be using the condom to ensure that they can last longer. The options, it is there. It's a matter of education. Ask your questions. Be told. And then choose the method that
works
best
for
you. And that is it. And then, if that method happens to fail, then we can say, hey, this one, the condom has broken, so we need something else. And there are people who haven't planned to have sex.
All right. So we will take a short break. We will come back to continue the conversation. This is Home Affairs on Joy 99.7 FM and also on Joy Prime.
Adriane dead, Yanko shot out and way. Onga, Onga chicken tablets. Onga, Adriane dead, Yanko shot out and way. Onga, Onga chicken tablets. Onga, why you and me do? Onga, why you and me do? Onga, why you and me do? Onga chicken tablets. Onga, in care this to me. In care this to me. Onga, Onga chicken. Kukwani hukime Edia ni die seweni Onga die lili Onga chicken tablet.
Introducing the new Onga chicken tablet.
This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Ah, Ofebia, did you brush your teeth before eating?
No, mommy. Anytime I use daddy's toothpaste, I get bruises in my mouth and sometimes I feel like vomiting.
Mm-mm, that's not an excuse. As a child, you need to brush your teeth before you take your breakfast to avoid tartar and cavity, okay? And you, why are you laughing at your sister? Have you brushed your teeth?
Yes, Mom. I used the Kel Kids toothpaste you brought yesterday to brush my teeth.
Well done, darling. Kel Kids toothpaste is made for kids like you from 2 years to 6 years.
It was so sweet like strawberry. I even wanted to eat it, Mom.
No, you can't eat it. It's toothpaste, not toffee, okay? It's always advisable to give your kids Kel Kids toothpaste to brush their teeth. Kel Kids toothpaste strengthens teeth and prevents decay and cavities. As a mother, I always make sure my kids use Kel Kids toothpaste. Kel Kids toothpaste with strawberry flavor makes brushing exciting for our kids.
Kel, happy, smart.
This advert is FDA approved.
Thank you for staying tuned in and for watching us. If you're just joining us, this is Home Affairs on Joy 99.7 FM and on Joy Prime. My name is Adam Knightite. I have been talking to Dr. Paddy Ayete. He is the medical director, consultant, OBS, gynae at Elimax Health. We actually have been answering your questions on, you know, female issues, woman issues. So if you have any, you have a sister, you have a daughter, you have a mother, a friend, or somebody whom you would like to be tuned in, even yourself, yeah? And we're taking your questions on 055-1111-997. And then our phone lines, we're activating a noun on 0302-216541. I have a question. Says that, please, my wife has been diagnosed with a condition called uterine hypoplasia. Doc, mm-hmm. is that it? Mm-hmm. A condition of the underformation of the uterus. Please, what are the other medical options to have a child? Ahead of that, one more time, do you know about the new Delicious? I am talking about the Ungalicious, and this is the new Delicious. Create more amazing moments with your favorite Unga seasoning, no matter your cooking experience. Unga is a delight to make great tasting meals in every home. Unga is convenient to use, and it brings out the aroma in all your meals. Unga is convenient again. So come on now, let's toast to the new Unga chicken tablet with superior taste and comforting aroma for all your chicken meals. Mama's helping hand, Unga proudly Ghanaian. Connect with the team at Unga and Unga Ghana on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Unga, Mama's helping hand. In a bit, I will be having a conversation with Adansi Travels, and we will talk about the power of aid. And again, they called, they answered, they conquered. So congratulations to all the winners of the new Geisha Black and Moringa game show, our natural girls and boys. We hope you finally got to experience the glowing, soft, moisturized, and smooth skin benefits from using the new Geisha African Strength Moringa and Black soap. So share your experience with us, because the world has to know about the new Geisha African Strength. And also know that it is ideal for all skin types, and we'll bring out the natural you. Share your story with us today. New Geisha African Strength, proudly African, made by Ghanaians and for fellow Ghanaians. T's and C's do apply. So the question about the uterine
hypoplasia.
Okay.
Yeah, great. It's a condition where the uterus was not formed properly.
From birth.
It doesn't form properly, and it's, or shall I say, maybe better yet, it's a condition where the uterus did not grow.
Mm. And what, you don't realize it until you grow up and
children? Yeah. You don't realize until you grow up and you're trying for children. For some people, their menses doesn't come at all.
Wow.
For some people, the menses comes, but the uterine size is small.
I see.
And it hasn't grown adequately to be able to carry a pregnancy.
So it can't carry a baby.
So as it is, it can't carry a baby. So if it's detected, you know, when a person is a little bit younger, there's a medication that we can give to try and cause it to grow a little bit. And for some people, that becomes adequate enough for them to carry. For some people, it's... Wow. At the stage at which it's detected, it's not something that can carry a pregnancy, and would therefore suggest or encourage them to have their pregnancy by a surrogate. We take his sperm, we take her egg, and combine it. When you have a baby with IVF, you put it inside a third person like you, and you carry it for them for 9 months. I know you have a big heart. You're so generous.
Ajay.
Gentlemen, please contact Adam.
I am going past.
She's willing and able. But those are that's very sad.
Possible.
It is a very, because you know the options are not that many.
Yeah.
When those things happen and
but
it's not a zero. You can still have.
Interesting. In all my conversations with Guyanese and all, that hasn't come up before. I didn't know there was a condition like that.
Yeah.
And the fact that you're unable to tell if you have a condition like that until you're checked out.
Oh no, that
doesn't sound too good. Hello, Del. Good morning. Please, anytime I have an engagement sexually with my wife on certain positions, she complains of pain at the abdomen lasting for about 10 minutes after or during the engagement. We have gone, I like you, seriously. You realize that we are on television and radio, so you're choosing your words very carefully. I like that. We have gone to see a gynae who has checked and confirmed there is nothing wrong and there is no cyst. Other flat positions seem to be fine. Oh, could you please maintain the question on the screen? I was just reading. Yeah, other flat positions seem to be fine without any pain, and that is what we're sticking to. But please, general view of what could be causing. Okay, so any general view of what could be causing the pain, can height be a factor? I am 6.2 feet and she's 5.4, and sometimes I feel her height can be. This is from Kweku.
You are a good man.
Yeah.
Your question is well put with, and we can feel your concern. There is a problem, but the problem is a position problem. So the what is happening basically is that you are kicking her in the balls when you adopt certain positions. And that is because her ovaries would lie to the back of the vaginal wall. And most probably, in certain positions, when the thrusting goes deep and you touch the back of the vagina, you are touching the ovary, you are impacting on the ovary, which is just behind the back of the vagina or the uterus in the particular location where it is. The result is that impact that is being transmitted onto the ovary is like somebody's hitting your balls. And
that bad?
Yeah, it can be. It's not like a kick to the balls, but it's like maybe a flick of a finger. The result, of course, is that at the end, she feels uncomfortable in the pressure, but at the end of the engagement, as you put it, she has this dull ache in the lower abdomen that will last for a little while until it goes down. The problem is with the way you guys position yourself in intercourse. And so you should find the positions that don't cause her pain and preferably stick to that. If you want to do any of the other positions, we need to change angle. Because like they say with the planes, there's something called the angle of attack. So if your angle of attack is such that it's in direct line with where the location of the ovary, the pain will be transmitted. If the angle of attack is tilted slightly by a few degrees, the impact will be towards a different side, and the result of which is that she will not have that pain. Usually, with this kind of condition, when you run tests, they'll find nothing. The problem is not with the disease process. It's just a matter of the fact that her, for lack of a better word, her balls are situated where when you go deep, you impact upon it.
I see.
Even if in the same encounter you don't go deep, and you reduce your degree of penetration by a centimeter or so,
it could be
no
okay.
pain.
Hello.
No pain.
So you can adopt the position, that same position, but just don't go as far as you normally go, and there'll be no pain.
Okay, great.
Problem solved.
All right.
Please
so
give us feedback to know.
Exactly.
Let us know whether it worked.
Next week, please give us feedback and let's see. So you've been given work today. Good morning. I have someone on the line.
Hello.
Belinda, hi. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Madam Eden. Please.
Hi, Belinda. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Great. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you guys?
We're well, thank you. Your question, Belinda.
Okay, so please, initially, around last year, I had, like, I was urinating, like, very frequently. Hello?
Yes, we're listening.
And then, I think later, I had this pain around my ovaries. This burning sensation.
Okay, is that all?
Then after, yeah, so later then, I started having the pain all over. From my head to down to my feet, I started having the pain all over. So I want to find out if there's something wrong.
How old are you, Belinda?
I'm 27 years.
Okay. Yes, there's something wrong. Please see your doctor. Yeah?
Okay.
Thank
it's
you.
It's as simple as that. Doc, someone wants to find out what is an orgasm.
Hey. Question. I think we should do a what do you call it, a poll, and ask people that what happens to you when you have an orgasm. But it's how should I put this?
It's the height of the engagement.
It usually occurs at the height of the engagement. Today, that's the operative word, engagement.
Yes.
Usually occurs
we
at
like
the height of the engagement, where there is a release of the excitement that has been built over the period of the engagement, which is quite satisfying. And the challenge
Hello?
Is when people are asking that question, then it usually means they are trying to figure out if
what it is,
if they have ever had one before. So, this one is he who feels it knows it. Eh?
Okay, Doc is struggling with this one.
When you have it,
you will know it.
You will know it.
Okay, we have Edward on the line. Hello, Edward. Oh, we lost Edward over there. Edward, sorry, please call us back. Okay, this will be the last question we'll be taking for today. It says, Adam, I float normally. And this is where, you know, the question seems to be contradicting itself. I flow normally, but it is so much that I use 2 boxes of sanitary pads. Sometimes I check my HB and it has dropped to 5. I am 49 and she's a quoi.
No, this is wrong. One, you shouldn't have, you know, periods that are that heavy.
Yeah, and so that's not normal.
That is not normal.
Great.
And HB of 5 is totally unacceptable.
Too low.
Totally unacceptable. Her problem is, the easier one is that she has a fibroid that is located in the middle of her womb,
mm-hmm.
where the baby sits, and that fibroid is what is causing the bleeding to be excessive. That is the simpler version. At her age, we are worried about the possibility that the bleeding may be due to a cancerous condition, and that is also a possibility for the kind of bleeding that she's having. Since she described it as heavy, then her definition of normal may not be what
exactly.
we also regard as normal. It could also be quite abnormal. So I would strongly suggest that she seeks medical care as quickly as possible. And there are options. Even with an HB that low, the trick is to try and stop the bleeding and then stop the menses and then try and remove, if possible, remove just the bleeding cause.
Okay.
That is when you can go from below, not cutting hair, but going to the womb and actually remove the cause of the bleeding. Because that one, you don't need a very high, you don't bleed.
Okay.
During the surgery. When we open you, you can bleed. So we need a lot of blood to be able to do that. When we do the minimal invasive surgery and we go through the vagina into the uterus and remove the bleeding, the cause of the bleeding, you don't bleed at all. So for that reason, we can do that for people with actually lower HBs. Because otherwise, getting your HB high is going to be very difficult. It's very difficult. So please see your doctor as soon as possible. You need urgent attention.
Great.
With an HB of 5, the slightest bleed you have again can kill you.
Uh-oh. Doc, that's brutal. Good morning, Frederica. Truth? Hello, Frederica. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Adam.
Yes, Frederica.
I thought...
Can hardly hear you. Please, could somebody help us hear Frederica better? Frederica,
Hello?
Please.
Hello.
Yes, Frederica.
I'm saying that last week I called and I processed for doctor. I sent a WhatsApp.
Can you hear Frederica? Frederica, please call us again. Your line is cracking. We can hardly hear you. I have a question here, and we will be, you know, this, if we have Frederica again, we'll answer Frederica's question, but we take this one and we will take a break and bring Adansi Travels into the studio to come and give us that exciting news this morning. Hello, Adam. I have been trying for a baby for more than a year. I do not have the urge to have sex, and most lubricants give me a burning sensation when I use it. What can I do to change this?
Most likely, there's something wrong with their hormones. Some people have burning sensation even without the lubricants. Having the most lubricants giving you a burning sensation, you have to figure out which one she's using, and if there are other alternatives that we could, you know, provide for her. But the other question is why she even needs lubricants in the first place. So a lot of things come to mind, and this is one of the cases that she would need to be. We need a lot more information to be able to provide her with the care that she needs, and she will need to see somebody, a specialist in that area, to address it. It's more than just what she thinks.
Okay. So she needs to go to
her
doctor. Okay, great. Adam, during some days when I want to get intimate with my husband, I feel stomach upset. Please, doc. Hey. Ask them if there's anything wrong with me.
Stomach upset that only comes about when you are about to have sex. Something is wrong. Something is definitely not right. Mm-mm.
That's a very...
So there's something wrong with you. I don't know whether it's in the head or it's in the body.
But this reminds me of a friend who says that she's allergic to her husband. God.
That one, we have to ask questions as to...
You see, coffee is on the line.
If what you are going to have is not something to look forward to,
okay,
it causes problems.
Great. Hi, Kobe. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
How are you, Kobe?
I'm good, and yourself?
We're well, thank you.
Yeah. And please, I want to find out, I have a girlfriend who seems to have if you're having an affair with her, she doesn't have orgasms.
Please lower the volume on your radio set, okay?
All right.
There's so much feedback. Thank you.
Okay.
Yes.
So, she hardly have orgasm, and she has, according to her, she has not have orgasm for a very long time, and anytime you seems to have any intercourse with her, she works, but it cuts. It's not that frequently. So I want to find out if, in this case, there is a problem with her.
Maybe not. It's if it's, as you said, it starts and then it cuts. It's obvious. It suggests that you still haven't figured out what her formula is. If she's something that she's had before but hardly has, it means at some point in time she has experienced what it is that actually allows her to successfully achieve an orgasm. And it's up to you, my good friend, to figure out what it is that she likes. This sounds more like a case of somebody who is not getting what it is that she needs to get to achieve an orgasm. And the two of you need to have a conversation and try and figure out ways to work it out. But it's solvable. This is one of the cases that is definitely solvable.
Okay, great. There's a question here, and it's boldened. Doc, I'm unable to pronounce that medical condition. What's that?
Hemorrhagic cyst.
Okay, is it cancerous? What's the lasting solution to this? Because now, after my last baby, medically, my uterus was removed.
A hemorrhagic cyst may not be is most likely not cancerous. A hemorrhagic cyst is essentially a cyst that you've bled into. There are multiple reasons why that can happen, but it's not necessarily mean that it has anything to do with cancer. So if it happens, it can be looked at and addressed. It's not that big a deal.
Okay. So Doc says it's not too much of a problem. But, so what? She still needs to go to the hospital?
Well, yeah, if it's persistent, you need to go to the hospital.
But what is it, though?
So you have, during ovulation, you have a follicle, and the follicle bursts to release the egg. And sometimes they bleed into the follicle.
Oh.
So the follicle, after it has burst, then you bleed inside. So then it forms a mass with blood clots and things inside.
I see.
And when we do a scan, we see a cyst, but by its characteristics, we suggest that it's hemorrhagic because we believe there's blood inside.
Okay.
But if you have your next menses, it goes down and it may actually go by itself.
Great. So we today, this is where we're ending our Q&A session with Dr. Paddy Ayete. But next week, Doc, next week you'll be here, right?
Next week I'll come.
Yay. Doc will be here next week, and then we will continue to take your questions. That would have been 3 weeks back to back. But our family members from Adansi Travels are here. Hello, Adansi.
Adam. Hello, Adam. It's always nice to be
How
here.
How are you doing?
Yeah, well,
we are fine.
I have Chuks and Ajua, right?
Yeah.
Yes, okay, great.
Doc.
Yes, sir.
You remember Chuks, right?
Oh, yeah, they're my buddy.
The party.
Yeah, we have to do another triple.
Of course, we should do another triple.
I'm waiting for you.
It's been a while, Doc. We should do another triple. All this talk of follicle and cold, we should
Dracula's
do another
triple. We haven't gone to Dracula's castle yet.
My favorite.
Which castle is that?
You promised me a trip to Dracula's hometown.
Ah, that's in Slovakia.
Slovakia, yeah.
My favorite memory of Chuks. That's God knows how many hours of walk on the streets of Venice looking for a
Chinese
restaurant. Oh my God.
Focus on you. Me and my squad, we've all lost.
It's okay.
And then please forgive me.
It was so much fun.
How's it going? Power of eight. Adansi is 8 years already. How's it going?
No, it's going very well. It's going very fine. Registrations are going through. We've outsold four dates already. We still have two more seats on the Rwanda slot, so seats are filling in fast.
As in two single seats?
Two single seats on the Rwanda slot, but we've outsold three seats already. Two for the Nairobi-Dubai route,
wow.
And we've outsold the one date for the Addis Ababa route. So, and we are still left with some few seats on the various dates. The
Kwame Eugene have a seat, though?
Yeah, Kwame Eugene has a seat. He has a permanent seat.
That is very, very important.
Yes. He has a permanent seat.
Okay. So you guys have been doing this for long, and some of us have experienced it. It's interesting that I am here with Dr. Paddy, and we both have been on, you know, we were together on a trip, so we know if we decide to go into those experiences, it won't end now. But
because
for what you're organizing now in view of the, you know, your 8th anniversary, what's the ultimate experience people should expect?
So the ultimate experience, we are looking at one, having our Artist of the Year on board. That is a Kwame Eugene Artist of the Year in Dubai. Where we
kindly speak up.
Oh, sorry. So the ultimate experience, like I said, is having our Artist of the Year on board, Kwame Eugene. We are going to bash in the desert. So that's a premium experience. Imagine yourself in the desert, in the middle of the desert, having a concert there with him playing all the hit songs back to back to back. Aside that, we'll also do that on a cruise, the Dubai Dhow cruise. He'll be on board, and we've gotten a very premium boat. He'll be on board bashing. We'll do this city tour and all, exploring other cities in conjunction with Dubai. So this is the experience we are giving people, twice the fun for the same price.
The local dish is still happening, right? The local food.
Yeah, I actually even wanted to add that. That's my favorite part. So, yes, we are bringing a local chef on board. So all the local meals in Ghana that you can think of is going to be on the desert. So whilst you are enjoying the Ghanaian high life music from Ebunebunu, Fufu, Banku, Bibia, just come. And then you'll just be eating and dancing along the music. Yeah.
Okay, great. So if anybody wants to be a part of the trip, what do they have to do like now?
Okay, so right now, since we are getting to the very end of registration, I think it is good to get the hotlines that we are using. So just pick up your phone, contact Hajara 059-558-8017 or 055-631-0404. 055-631-0404. So you can contact Hajara now and you can just book your spot. You can just register with just 1,000 Ghana cedis and then pay the rest later on and you are on board.
Are there deadlines?
Yes, right now, actually, the deadline was supposed to be yesterday. But because we are coming on board here, we just wanted to extend the deadline further. So by Friday, next week Friday, that's the 30th of July, we are closing registrations. The funny thing is that it may not even get there because people are rushing for the seat. So yeah, we are encouraging all those who are interested to just come on board now so that they don't find themselves seeing sold out.
Great. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Please, I am requesting special package or something for my listeners right now. Yao, do magic.
The special package, you said, I think
actually,
you should tell your listeners you're on board. So the special package is even you yourself going, so your listeners will get a chance to interact with you there.
My boss hasn't granted me yet.
Well, I've let the cat out of the bag already, so your listeners should expect to join you. But aside that, we have what we call, for the first 10 people who are going to book on your show now. We are going to give them an Adansi branded Visa card with spending shopping money on it. They are going to spend for free. Ordinarily, we wouldn't have given this, but coming here, home our first listeners, we know how dear they are to you and them. So for the first 10 people.
You know, when I was going on my trip, they showed me a lot of love.
Love. So for the first 10 people who would call our numbers this very minute and book with 1,000 cities, will get an Adansi branded Visa ATM card, which they can use to shop in Dubai. It has shopping money on it. We'll put money on it for them to shop in Dubai.
Please quickly put the number out again.
So 059-55-00-817.
Okay.
I think I got it wrong the first time. 059-55-00-817. The second one is 055-631-0404.
Okay.
055-631-0404.
Okay, great. But I mean, all I'm waiting for is for my boss to grant my leave, and I surely will be on that trip because, Charlie, my kids, their bags are packed already. So
I hear that.
Be on that trip. But quickly, before we go, I mean, thank you very much, Shooks and Ajua, for being on the show.
Yeah,
I just would like to put Doc's the hospital line out there so that people won't come back to, you know, keep asking. And, you know, so 024-807-5568. Number again is 024-807-5568 if you want to contact Elimas Health. All right. Thank you all very much for doing the listening and watching us. Next week, 6:15, we're back on your television and radio. My name is Adam Knightstay, and thanks to the crew led by Mauli and Daniela, God bless all of you. Bye-bye.